Hello.
David Tucker. How are you?
Hello. I'm okay. How are you guys?
Good. Are you on the phone?
Unfortunately, I'm in this kind of in the middle of nowhere state. It looks like we might be able to come home later this week. So by next week, I should be able to have normal meetings and normal with video and everything. But right now, it's still low fidelity.
Okay.
Like bring the baby home and everything?
What's that?
Like you'll be able to bring the baby home and everything?
Yeah, exactly. Like it depends on him passing the breeding test, getting the breeding badge on Thursday. If he passes that test, he's welcome to come home.
So awesome.
So it's not certain that he will, because this has been the reason why we've been staying for a very long time, is because it still has this premature breeding apnea, I think is what it's called. Technically, but he just stops breathing, and then he starts again. So we need to be sure that he always starts again before we can go home, basically.
Of course. Well, David, we hope that little baby Hunter will pass the test.
Right, thank you. Keep all your fingers crossed for us. And if all goes well, I might be able to show you, probably not, but I might be able to very soon show you some give you a quick demo of Mini Tensor here.
Oh! I think everyone would be very happy to see Mini Tensor.
A quick demo.
That's awesome.
A quick demo, right?
I'm so technical, aren't I?
I'm David, demoing my baby.
I know.
Yeah, baby Tensor is going to be the next unicorn.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it could be, right? Yep. It'll have to be very quickly, though, because he's sleeping most of the time. But anyway, sorry. I'm gonna put myself on mute, but I'm still here.
Okay, so if anyone wants to talk to David or squeeze a joke out of him, you know he's there. You just can't see his blonde hair today. So, Rob, welcome. Hello. So I think we have most of the people here. It's also 5 past, and welcome to a wonderful SUMO meeting today, live from the London studio. Joining me, Yusuf.
Hello.
I can't see Yusuf's face.
Oh, really?
Oh, now I can.
Yeah, that's better.
Oh, yeah.
Wait. Everything.
Right. Can you see us both now? Because our selfie shows us both.
No, it's okay.
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay,
Yusuf,
good.
Is your computer pink?
No, it's red.
Okay, because it looks very pink.
No, I can attest that it's red.
Okay.
I ran up my sweater. So. Anyway, so Yusuf and myself, we were at the Moss Fest this weekend for all of you fans of the Mozilla Foundation and the Webmaker program. It was a lot going on, right? And very interesting sessions and things.
So I was volunteering for most of it, so I only managed to get to one session about PGP and security on the internet. And that one was interesting. They got everybody set up PGP encrypted emails and sent emails to each other like that. So I mean, that was interesting, but for the rest of it, I was volunteering, helping out with all the logistical stuff.
So as you see, our volunteers, so we're making a puzzle. You were making a puzzle for a lot of people to attend sessions, right?
Yes.
We got something interesting, by the way, for anyone interested. We've been working on the Buddy spreadsheet, and we got some ideas on how to make that happen, right?
Yes.
So
we have the chat somewhere.
And we also met Ashikur from Bangladesh, who is another buddy. And we have a picture with Robert and...
Yes, we also have ABC, who's SUMO contributor on the forums. And he's in IRC now, so if you want to say hi to him, you can do that.
Right. ABC. So he's just a very, very, very nice guy. And, you know, just to tell you a little bit, we gathered together, we have a couple of pictures, you know, with Ashikur, with Robert, so we were trying to make a little SUMO community picture there. And, and Eddie Steve, he's also product manager based in London, so he might help us with the forums. I told him, like, we would love to pick your brains on you know, how to design the forms better, because you're a forum user and a product manager, so we hope to get him involved a little bit more with that. So that's a little update, right?
Yeah.
From the
that's in a nutshell.
Yeah. So that's it. Now let's go to the Etherpad and start saying. So we kind of like jump into like the roundtable topics and talk about the MOSFETs, but we can talk also about the SUMO development update. This week it is on you, Ricky.
Okay, I'll make it quick. So the main thing we're working on as far as the roadmap items is so far in this sprint is the show floor, where we're adding support for Firefox OS and other products, and or ability to add new products in the future. And there's a proposal in the bug, and we're waiting on info from Birdie. I don't know if you've seen that yet, Birdie, but if you can get to that.
I did. I was looking at it on Friday. Kadir and I are going to meet after this. I need to talk it through with somebody.
Okay.
So
you can invite me if you want.
I'll answer that today.
Okay, cool. So, yeah, I won't go into the details, but basically, Show 4 was designed for Firefox desktop, where it made sense to have multiple operating systems and versions. And now in a product base, we want to break it out into products as well. So you could have, like, four Firefox OS or whatever. But yeah, we're still exploring that, and then we'll implement it. One thing we're waiting on is the support forum for Serbian and Hungarian. I don't know if we can turn those on yet or not, but
we can if you want to, but I'd rather wait.
Okay, that's cool. So yeah, whenever. And we did enable Slovenian like last week or something, but no questions have been asked yet as far as I did see. And yeah, you can go through our links to see all the rest of the bugs. There's a ton of like one-off bugs, small improvements, but nothing huge. Yeah, I'll leave it there.
Okay.
Or do your own homework.
Do your own homework. So anything we can help you with, Ricky? Anything you need help, like testing, new ideas you need?
Is that a question for me or?
Yeah, I said Ricky, no?
Oh, sorry. I was zoned out. No, we're good. We don't need anything.
Okay, cool. Thank you. Well, that sounds like Serbian and Hungarian. They're coming soon. Lena is on top of that. Very cool. So we can go on with the roundtable items. I see the SumoWires at the Brussels summit. That's a picture, right? You posted that? Birdie.
Yeah,
Birdie.
That was me. I keep forgetting to post the darn thing. I just I just did.
Oh, that's a very cool picture. So who are they? Can you, I mean, just quickly so that we get an idea of who was there. You remember that? So cool.
Oh boy, I don't know if I can remember everybody's names. Let's see. Well, there's Yusuf there in the front row.
So maybe maybe we can ask Michael, we can ask our contributors to maybe put underneath the photo on the Etherpad or anywhere who was there, so that we can start, you know, putting names to faces or nicknames to faces, right? So we have a better idea of our...
I should be able to make it so that you can, like, put a note by each person, like, on the
right.
Photo. I forget how to do that in Flickr. I'll look at it.
Yeah, don't worry. It's just like people can help, and then they can say like, "That's me. That's very cool." Who's the girl?
Ibai, was she from Serbia?
She was from Serbia. Yes.
I don't remember her name.
Okay, cool.
Me neither, unfortunately.
Okay, cool. Well, if you happen to know everyone on IRC, if you happen to know someone in the picture, or if you can tag yourself, you can say, yeah, that's me. I think that would be great, because the idea is to put all the pictures together and have like a SUMO community picture from all the summits, right? So maybe we'll add all the faces then. I think that would be a lot of fun.
Yeah,
we have a picture from Santa Clara. Yeah. Cool, so let's go. Firefox for desktop. Tyler, is it you that's taking it this week?
Yeah, so Firefox 25 comes out tomorrow. There's not really any big changes for users, except the fact that the find bar is no longer shared between tabs. so that new functionality may confuse a few users. There are some big changes for support, though. So if you reset Firefox 25, now migrates your open windows and tabs, which is one of the biggest complaints that we have with Firefox Reset.
There's
a lot of feedback. Can you mute?
Thank you.
Hey, Robert.
Robert, right here.
I'll come and get you.
Here we go.
I'll come and get you. I'll be back in a minute.
And then
we're getting Robert in the same room.
Awesome. And then the last thing is, if you don't open Firefox 25 for at least, I believe it's 60 days, it will prompt you to reset Firefox. We're not going to notice that, obviously, for 2 months, but that is something that will help those users that install Firefox get frustrated with it, move to another browser, and then come back later on. That'll help them maybe resolve any issues that they were having with Firefox that caused them to leave in the first place.
Okay.
Yeah. It'll be nice, like, when we have updates and you see, like, ooh, there's new cool stuff, and they want to try it out, and they haven't used it in a long time. This'll be nice.
That sounds good. So we're going to keep on everyone posted on that. Tyler, did you also completed this week the Firefox for Android part? Do you
yes.
want to take that or anyone has any questions?
Yeah, Firefox 25 comes out tomorrow for Android as well. Surprise, surprise. Big new feature is guest browsing. You can hand your phone to a friend, turn on guest browsing, and they can use your phone to browse the internet and not get all of your personal data in their browsing session. The other big change is mixed content blocking is now on for Firefox for Android as well. We turned that on for desktop a few releases back. And Android will get all of that extra security now. We don't have very many complaints about it on desktop, so we're not expecting any complaints for Android, but just something to keep in mind. Other than that, there's some minor back-end fixes for both releases, but nothing else user-facing.
Okay, sounds good. So everyone posted. Any questions? Otherwise, just a little interruption. I'll go back to Firefox in a little moment. But we have Robert here. He was also helping at MozFest, being very awesome, and we're very happy to have him here.
Thank you.
Robert, do you want to tell the group a little bit about yourself?
Sure. I think I know Matt from Toronto. He did some. Hello, Matt. I'm in Chicago, so I'm a Mozilla rep. I started with you guys with support. Now I'm kind of doing all kinds of like web maker, marketing things, events. So that's my background right now.
Yeah. So you got onboarded at Mozilla through Army of Awesome?
Yes.
There we go. SUMO successfully, you know, bringing people into the project, and now you're a rep now, right?
Yes. Sure.
So just a little to give you a little background on Robert. Robert was rambling everyone at MozFest. He was like with his walkie-talkie, helping everyone find the right floors, coordinating a lot of logistics with the volunteers, and he worked hard. I mean, like every day, like 25 hours, right?
Yeah. That was awesome.
Yeah, so he was doing a great job, and I was very happy to find out that, you know, when I found you and mm-hmm. Eddie and Edward and Yusuf, like, we were all Sumonians, and we didn't know that, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Trying to get the Sumo community together and to spread the word, so
yeah.
Very, very, very glad to have you here.
Thank you.
Yeah. So that's it. If you have any questions or if you want to know a little bit more about Robert, you know, he's here. He's also on our Sumo page.
I just want to say hi. Hi.
Hello.
I remember you from email. I was like, I know you.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, hi. Good to meet you.
Hello.
Yeah, isn't it great when you finally put like a face?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, well, I've been working with Yusuf, for instance. We've been working like for a year together, and
yeah.
This is the first time we actually meet in person, so it's
mm-hmm.
it's always very exciting.
Yeah.
I hope Adina and Robert, you get the chance to meet in person too.
Yeah, definitely.
So yeah, that's it. And now that we had a little intermezzo, let's talk about Firefox OS, because I think there's big news, right? Fermina, you want to take that over? Or Rob, I don't know who of you wants to take this today?
Yes, of course. So I've also seen that that Michelle said something in on the interface. So we've launched last week in Brazil with LG and Alcatel phones. We're still waiting for first pieces of feedback from there. We are analyzing it it now. The feedback we started receiving for input. I had a sync with Telefonica as well last week to see how it went. They were very happy with the launch, and they promised that they are going to share with us some information, emailing information, with more detailed information. So I will probably be able to update you more on this beginning of next week at our next meeting. I think this point on working on problems we had.
Oh yeah, I just want to thank everyone for their help on forums last week. We're still working on a couple of issues, a couple of users from who got the update from Spain, but we haven't seen new incidents. And I think I see people getting updated to 1.1 on the Mozilla Hispano forum over the weekend. Ralph, did you read those threads? Do you have an update for us? I don't see an update on my LATAM build yet this morning. Hermina, I know that we thought Movistar was going to do that last week. Did you have an update from them on?
No, I had a call tomorrow with them. So I will probably have an update tomorrow, and I will let her know. Nothing yet.
Okay. Yeah, ask them if they've pushed it. I haven't seen it yet. Ralph, have you seen on your phone?
No.
No, okay, we haven't seen 1.1 for the Colombia-Venezuela phones yet, but we did get some good updates from ZTE last week on the issue from the couple of people we have with issues from Spain.
Okay, that's good. So Everything's going well there, Michelle. Do you need any help or contributors to?
No, thanks to everyone who's been helping on the English forum and anyone who's helping on the Mozilla Hispano forum. Great stuff. And I know Madalena sent an update. Madalena, thanks for helping with Camp Firefox in Germany, the support site for all of our German users, and it sounds like phones are starting to ship from Kongstar now, so maybe this week we'll hear something from people in Germany, right?
Yep. So hopefully there'll be some news soon, but we're ready, so we can handle those. That's fine.
Yes. Well, thanks for getting the separate forum set up. I appreciate it.
Okay, that sounds very good. Anything new? Otherwise, I think that we can go on a little bit to talk about metrics. Kadir isn't here. Roland isn't here to talk about Thunderbird, but since there are no updates, I assume that things are going smoothly there. The metrics part, does anyone want to take that over for Kadir? Otherwise, I'll just go and read it. I don't know if
I can. Yeah, I can just explain. This was something that we talked about last week, and Kadir and I looked at it right after the meeting and added it to last week's Etherpad, but I just wanted to follow up. When we were looking at the KPI dashboard, there was this like pretty big spike in the knowledge base helpfulness, like on one day. And this is the type of thing that I try to point out a lot. It turns out, our engagement team, they have this monthly newsletter that they send out, and this last month they did one about using the full screen feature in Firefox, and that newsletter linked to the full screen article on Sumo, and over the course of about a week, like 100,000 people clicked through from the newsletter to read the Sumo article, and on the main day that everybody got the newsletter, there was like 4,000 something yes votes on that article, and that's what bumped the helpfulness up like 5% on that day. Pretty cool when that happens.
That's cool. Okay, that sounds like that's helping a lot. And let me see the spike you have in there. Oh, very cool. So you can see, everyone can check the graphic that's posted, that's linked from the Etherpad. If you want to check it out, it's amazing, right? How it just goes up. So that's pretty cool. What else? I think for our metrics, I don't know if someone else has anything to say about the metrics. Otherwise, in terms of contributors, we have a lot of contributors. Things are looking well. So thanks everyone for being part of SUMO and for bringing new people in and helping them get started. Things are looking good. And then, so if you don't have any questions, Michael, you could continue with the knowledge base. Do you have any updates?
Well, yeah, no big update there. I mean, the biggest thing is I put it actually under contributors of the week. So last week, if you guys weren't aware, we blocked all versions of the Java plugin. And there's some particular cases. There's a weird technicality where the plugin gets called and then deleted, and then you don't get the interface for activating the plugin. And so tons of people were having an issue with that, went to the article and was like, hey, this article's not helping me because I actually don't see that interface. And Alice and Philip were all over this issue. They instant messaged me to let me know. They updated the article, answered questions on the forum. It was really awesome that they took care of that last week. I was at the tribe thing when this was all going on, and so that was super, super cool that they did that. So I just wanted to say thanks.
Thank you guys. That sounds very good. It's always incredible to see, you know, when someone's not there, everyone, you know, someone else can take over and fill the gaps. That's great. So I wanted to talk about localization, and I know that we've been talking a lot about Firefox OS, so maybe for the next weeks, we're going to start concentrating on other issues or other, you know, subjects on localization. I just wanted to say, this week, last week I wasn't so prepared, but the German community is rocking, like it's going out of style. I just want to say, for a long while, like our you know, Thomas has been very busy, and it's, you know, he has been leading the community for so many years, but then suddenly everyone just, you know, they all got together, and we have some new contributors doing great things. We have new moderators. We have Andy, for instance, is doing an amazing work. And we brought back desktop articles, you know, to 100%. I think they went down a little bit now, 90%, but still, I mean, it's great coverage. And we have a very short notice for the Firefox OS launch in Germany. And the Germany community just pulled together and did everything. So I just wanted to say that this week, like, a huge thank you. And, you know, I think this is a very sort of like an inspiration for other communities. Even if your community is starting to slow down, you know, sometimes it's just a little kick and everyone gets back together. So I just wanted to say thank you so much. Vielen Dank, die deutsche Community. you're doing an amazing work. So, and I think that deserves the recognition here. So thanks a lot. And other than that, I just wanted to mention that we're going to bring out some new Firefox OS articles. Michael's going to finish them this week. And then we're going to have our set of Firefox OS articles. One thing that I've been seeing while checking all these articles is that we have them translated in languages like Hindi and Japanese and Korean. And I wanted to thank everyone who's translating Firefox OS articles. Also, I wanted to, you know, let you know that if you're not sure if Firefox OS is launching in your country, you can always ask me how the priorities are, because sometimes you spend a lot of time translating those articles and we might change them, or maybe the version that comes, that is launched in your country is like 1.3, so a lot of the content that you translated will be outdated by then. So if you have any questions, you can always contact me, and I can help you prioritize the content that you can work on next, right? Maybe we need some more help first on desktop and then on mobile. I know everyone's very excited about Firefox OS. But if you have any doubts, contact me and I can help you prioritize the content. We are thinking about ways of solving those issues, I mean, solving that on a product side. But so far, I know you're excited and you want to translate, of course, go for it. But if you want to be sure that, you know, the content that you're translated is going to be out, you know, it's going to be, you know, that one that goes out, you can always ask me. So that's what I wanted to say to everyone. Don't get overwhelmed with all the content. I don't know if, yeah, we will be keeping you updated on that front. And as always, you can ask. And if you don't have any questions, I think that Mina, you can take over and talk about the forum.
Thanks. Okay, so if we didn't say it enough, I'll say again, thanks to the German community for making the Firefox OS forum happen. We had a bit of bumps there because we're supposed to launch and then somebody got sick and it was like a big mess. But in the end, we did it. So thanks so much for doing it. And they also for driving the discussions there because there are already some discussions. So well done. I'm looking forward to see what kind of questions will appear. I hope not too many when we finally get to actually chip. So thanks for that. You German guys rock. And another thanks to everybody helping out on the forum because we're now almost constantly on 100%. So that's an amazing work. Thanks so much. And it's not only Firefox OS, it's also desktop and Android. So we're actually supporting three products with our forums, and that's a lot of work. So thanks so much for all your efforts. One more thing, if you could check whoever is involved with the forums, if we could check the bugs that are filed there, I have put the link in the Etherpad. These are features that are meant to help bringing the solved rate up. So if you have any questions or concerns or any comments on that, please do comment on the bugs because they're currently programmed to go soon in the next sprint. So please check that. And last but not least, congrats to Andrew, also known as Fear56, sorry, who just became a moderator on the forum. So woohoo! Well done.
Very cool.
And that's it. If you have any questions, you know where I am. Here.
Fantastic. Thank you, Melina. I just realized that I forgot to put it on the roundtable topics, but we got a lot of feedback from, especially Melina and I in our session in Santa Clara at the summit. We got a lot of feedback that this meeting was kind of boring, right? Like, we had a lot of updates and, you know, we were just thinking about maybe we talk a lot about Firefox OS, which is very important in the country's launching, but maybe your country's not next on the list. So you're kind of bored. Or maybe there's a lot of things that we talk about that aren't so interesting for everyone. So we really want to know what's interesting for you, what kind of things you think should be here, shouldn't be here, if you'd rather have like a short version of the meeting. So we just want to pick your brains on ideas to make this meeting more meaningful for you. So I put an Etherpad. Just go crazy if you think we should, you know, have ice cream, or I don't know, just whatever you think that will make this meeting really meaningful and interesting for you, and what you think should be better. Just go and tell us on the Etherpad. We are thinking about how to restructure these meetings, how to make them, you know, productive and interesting for everyone. Also, if you want to say no, I love the meeting the way I are, they are, just go for it. That's also a very good feedback.
Any kind of ideas are welcome, so don't be afraid to ask for the impossible.
Exactly. And so that's our ask. You know, if you have any ideas, let us know. I think that's really
can
community.
Can you hear me?
Sorry.
This is David. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Hello. So I just wanted to add that I think also what would be helpful is to maybe not even think about the meeting per se, but think about, consider what type of information you would like to get from the project and what type of discussions you would like to see. So the answer might be, I'm not saying that it is, but the answer might be that a lot of the things that we are talking about in this meeting could happen in the contributor forum, for example. And it might be that this meeting could be something completely different, that is filled with other discussions that can't really happen in the forum, or for whatever reason shouldn't happen in the forum. So when you think about the content of this meeting, think about the communication, you know, across the board with the project. And please do help Rosanna and Madalena with that, you know, feeding the Etherpad with your feedback.
And to tag on to that, I just added two things to that Etherpad, which is, I think, in my mind, the same thing that David was just saying. Imagine if, for instance, the kind of updates and stuff that we do in this meeting was just a blog post or contributor forum post or, you know, something like that. And instead of a, like, meeting, we had, you know, more like office hours with a rotating cast of staff and contributors on hand on video to answer questions, you know, and have just a general chat about SUMO and whatever things are, you know, currently you want to know about.
I think that's a good idea. We should all add all of our ideas. I think that makes sense. We had also ideas about featuring one community every week, for instance, right? So we know, you know, SUMO around the world, you know, what's going on, and, you know. So there's a bunch of ideas, and we can mix them, right? We don't have to have the same. And we've been also experimenting, like, for instance, like the unicorn and all of those things. And, you know, if you seriously think that it's not so interesting, then, you know, we can do different things and, you know, mm-hmm. kind of like getting the best format, right? We can't see the ratings, right? I mean, you don't see how many people, like, so anyway, that's the idea. And, of course, to make this more, you know, more interesting for everyone. So again, if you have any ideas, go all crazy on that Etherpad, and if you want to start a discussion on the support forum, that's also cool. But the Etherpad will be great to gather all of those ideas. And, you know, think about communication channels, what needs to be here, what needs to be maybe on the forums. I know some people are very keen to have a SUMO meetup, like with all the SUMO people. You know, not everything might be possible, but just think about that, because I think that that makes a lot of sense. And with that, I think that we can have the contributors of the week, and I would love to have someone else read them. Maybe Yusef and Robert, you can read through the contributors of the week.
Sure. I think Michael's already gone over Alice and Philip, so I won't go back on that one. So I'll do the one by Michelle. She's put forward Andrew, Fear 56, Jay Kumar, and Eddie C for all the contributions they've done on the Firefox OS forums last week, which obviously was when things were most crazy. So yeah, she says thank you for all your help and all the support. Yeah. Gonna do
German one.
Okay, so one is going to be the German community. It's rocking. support.mozilla.org/ve/. I guess that's the.
That's the link where you can see the German community and who has been active.
Right. So I'm not sure who. They don't tell you who actually nominated the.
Oh yeah, I nominated the German community, and Madalena put the nomination for Hagen, maybe.
Okay. Yeah, I think that if they did an outstanding job and they are working really hard to get their community back up and going, so I certainly would think that's a
very good
thing.
Great. Yeah, I wanted to say thank you also. Like, now that I'm here with you guys
in
person,
right.
I wanted to say thank you for, you know, like, I know you started at SUMO and you're taking other responsibilities at Mozilla, but I think that you tell everyone about SUMO and you're still proud SUMOians.
Yeah.
And that is great. Thank you so much, because we need, you know, we need guys like you that are at other parts of the project telling people about SUMO.
I still want to continue on, especially over Twitter. I'm really big in social media. I had to scale back just a little bit because I kept on getting my Twitter account locked by Twitter.
Really?
Yeah.
So another Twitter lock.
Yeah. So
that's our pain with Army of Awesome. So this is how we know that that people contribute a lot. They just get their accounts blocked. Sorry about that. We're still working on it.
Very cool. So I don't see any unicorn show and tell. Crossing my fingers, next week it will be Mini Tensor. Mm-hmm. But if it's not, we'll wait until Mini Tester is ready to come and see us, right?
Well, I can show you a picture if you want.
Oh, yeah.
This is this might give you a good size comparison.
Oh.
Look at this. Oh, sorry, Michelle. I'm still in your thunder there. Sorry about that. You can see that it's small at these, right?
That's very sweet, David. It's a selfie with baby.
I couldn't see anything. Oh, now.
Yeah, me either.
Ah, sorry.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, now I can see it. Is that considered
tiny.
A selfie?
Yeah.
A group selfie?
Well, I mean, Mini Tensor is kind of part of David, right? So it's like a selfie and a half.
Sweet.
It's very sweet, David. It's very, very moving to see you with the Mini Tensor.
Oh, and David has a haircut too, right?
Thank you. I did, yeah. I did it myself. So don't
really?
Comment on it. Yeah.
Okay, no comments on David's haircut.
Yep, please.
Very good. So, I think that, David, thanks for sharing that photo. Everyone's very happy for you, and we all hope that, you all get back together.
Thank you so much. Yep. Thank you.
Fantastic. So, let me see. Decision and action items for next week. We will talk a little bit more about the ideas on the Etherpad and how to make this meeting better. Right? We can do that next week. So I think that's about it. Does anyone have anything else they want to get off their chest? Anything you guys want to share? Or?
No, I'm excited to be here.
Okay, I'm really excited to have both of you here. It's the first time I have a SUMO meeting. Two contributors live, so I'm very excited about it. Thanks everyone this week for making things work well, for keeping SUMO going, and we'll see you next week. Have a great week. Enjoy.
Bye, everybody.
Thanks, guys. Bye.
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 Bye, everyone.